nice day to do that.
Be
in the water, especially.
Yeah, especially in the water. It's been very hot. We topped out in the 90s again. Surprise. I don't know if you're shocked or not at this point, but we're consistently going to be in the 90s here is what our 7-day forecast is looking like, and that is right on track with this climatology for this time of year. So today we got up to 94 degrees, and we started off right at 79, so still very, very humid. That humidity means we've had really warm mornings, so those low temperatures near 80, that actually bumped us for the month of May to the warmest May on record with a average temperature up above 80 degrees. So very, very warm for the rest of this month. Our high temperatures on average continue to increase about 3 degrees from 90 to 93. So very, very warm. Right now, a little bit of activity going on over towards Louisiana and Texas near the Houston area, as well as out towards West Texas. But for us right now, we are pretty quiet and calm. Thankfully, we did see a pretty decent amount of thunderstorms. You could see it right there at the end of the loop moving offshore. That was earlier today, earlier this afternoon, moving through this area in the morning. 90 right now in Corpus Christi, and we are going to stay pretty warm and humid heading into tonight. 80s by about 10:30. Now heading into this evening, we are going to be watching for some storms potentially to move across the coastal bend and our South Texas area here. Some of these could be having some gusty winds as well as some hail, so we could be looking out for that heading into tomorrow, but hopefully this should be coming across when you're asleep and offshore by the time you are waking up. 81 for our temperature tomorrow morning, then heading into the afternoon, 94 for our high temperature, then heading into Monday morning, first week of not school, of summer break, it's going to be quite humid, start 82 there. Now heading into the rest of this week, we are going to see again another chance for some storms heading into Monday night, so we'll keep you updated on that. And then we're going to continue to see the humidity stream in with these southeasterly winds. Unfortunately, we are not going to see this cold front come down into the state of Texas really anywhere at all, maybe up to the Red River Valley, and that's about it. We're going to have high pressure building in. This is upper atmosphere high pressure, but you can also see a couple different high pressures, kind of this clockwise motion. Those are at the surface. This high pressure, though, this is the one that's going to make us really hot and sunny over the summer. So it's the one we've been talking about. It's kind of ebbing and flowing, but you can also see whenever I peel back all of that surface stuff to the upper levels of the atmosphere, you can see how the winds come around on the eastern side of that high pressure. Whenever that happens, that air dries out. So we could be seeing a little bit drier air heading into this coming week, but that actually means temperatures can warm up a lot easier. So it's kind of a trade-off. It's still going to be hot. It's still going to be humid. And we could also see a few impulses of energy move around that side of the high pressure, sparking further rain chances, because we have plenty of moisture and heat in the atmosphere to fuel storms. High temperatures each day right around 94, 95. Today, the first day of hurricane season, thankfully a very quiet start to the season. We did not see any storms preseason. That is the first time since 2022, and that's only the second time in the last 10 years. NOAA, like y'all heard earlier, is expecting a very active year, 17 to 25 named storms. You'll get our KIII forecast in our hurricane special airing right after our newscast. So a very hot day tomorrow, high temperatures in the 90s, with a feels like temperature up to 112. Brian.
Thank you very much.